They think small town America is fading away. Evidently, they haven't been to some of the places we have, including where we are today. Hi, this is Norm Allen with you on another Out of the Norm show where the stories are all about you. Today, we're in downtown Bentonville, Arkansas, little town of about 30,000 people in northwest Arkansas. Beautiful little place, but it's also the world headquarters for the world's largest retail store, Walmart. We're going to talk about Walmart a little bit, but mainly we're going to talk about the lifestyle here in beautiful Bentonville, Arkansas, that it's a safe place to live. People know each other by name. They wave when they drive by, and they're concerned about their neighbors. Nope, small town America is not gone, and we're going to give you a little glimpse of what it's like right here on the Out of the Norm show, where the stories are all about you, so please don't go away. Hey, you think small town USA has gone away? It has not gone away in Bentonville, Arkansas. Not only is it a beautiful square that we've been seeing some pictures of earlier, but it's also a place that has personality. And that personality comes from the leadership of a community. And Diana Ike, right here at the Bentonville Convention and Tourist Bureau, I got that right, didn't I?
Yes.
She is one of those voices of Bentonville that people take home her personality wherever they go. I thank you for being a part of the Out of the Norm show.
Thank you. Thank you.
This is fun. I just fell in love with your town just walking around, and people are so friendly and nice. Of course, that's Arkansas. Good. That's anywhere.
Yes.
What makes Bentonville different from, say, Little Rock or Texarkana or El Dorado, some of the other larger towns in the state of Arkansas?
I think what makes Bentonville very unique is just that even though there seems to be lots of activity, lots of numbers, lots mm-hmm. of folks, we still have that very community feel where you recognize people on the street that you pass, maybe even in your car, you know, passing, honk, hello, and that type of thing.
And you told me a story earlier today about a lady who thought she was insulting you by calling this a Mayberry.
Oh, yes, yes, she did. She was very surprised that I would choose to live in a little small town such as this, a Mayberry in the middle of nowhere. And I told her, most definitely, that is, I'm very proud.
What a compliment, isn't it?
It was a definite compliment. I have three children, and I feel very safe for them to be, you know, walking around our square and our town, and their friends, you know, may come by. I had one earlier pop his head in and say hello to me, and it's just a very nice.
And you told me about your son going by and getting jelly beans from
yes,
the store owner.
Yes, my youngest son has to make his trip by one of our store owners to get jelly beans, so yes.
So this idea of maybe, it's really relevant to the story, but do you realize that every 24 hours, every minute of the day that Andy Griffith's show with Mayberry is on somewhere in the world,
that's
a fact,
right.
24 hours a day.
Okay.
And the reason is, it's the picture of America mm-hmm. that the rest of the world misses mm-hmm. or wants to see. But you live it right here, don't you?
We do. We do. And I'm, you know, again, very proud of that fact, is that we have that small hometown feel, yet are so progressive in, you know, the projects that we have going and what we give back to the community.
Now, when Walmart first, of course, that was back in the 50s,
mm-hmm.
but when that first happened, this town was only, what, 3,000 or 4,000 people?
Oh, yes, very small, very small.
And now we're up to?
Probably pushing upper 30s, up 38, maybe 1,000, something like that.
And your unemployment rate here?
We have a very low unemployment rate here. We typically are about 3% lower than the rest of the state. And I just read earlier the state was at 7.9,
right.
Something like that, a little lower. So we're usually 2 or 3% less than.
Okay, you're talking us into it now.
Yeah.
There's plenty of work here. If you want to work, you can work in the Bentonville area.
That's exactly right.
What about the cost of living here as compared to other parts of the country?
We have a very, very low cost of living that, you know, is, again, we have the amenities available to us. The shopping. We have some very neat shopping right here.
You have
here
a new art center
square.
Opening soon.
We do have.
Tell me a little bit about that.
We have the Crystal Bridges.
Yes.
Is a Alice Walton Family Foundation project, and that will be it's American Art Museum, and once it will be opening up and bringing a kind of a whole new dimension to our square. But I feel very strongly that it will only add to the quality
sure.
that we have here. And
Well, that's another question. I mean, we talked about the growth and how it's gone from 4,000 or 5,000 to almost 40,000 mm-hmm. people. Mm-hmm. But the city has kept up with that with services and streets and amenities for people who come in, haven't they?
Yes, yes. Or have kept up or in the process of. We have quite a bit of street work going on right now, widening of roads and that such thing.
But it's preparing for the future.
It is. It is. I had a visitor in earlier this morning also that was described it to me, and I thought it was kind of hit it right on the head, that the folks that move into the area, they move into the area because of the way that we are, because of the small town feel. They come here and they adapt to us.
Right.
They don't try to come in and say, well, where we lived, we did such and such. And he was noticing that, being one himself. He
sure.
said he had moved from Florida.
Right.
And has been here a couple of years, and he said, you know, that it's really neat to be able just to kind of move into the community, very welcoming community, mm-hmm. and be a part of it.
Well, and it's not, also, you're not a primary retiree area. This is a
right.
whole vast scope of families
right.
with children. Great place to go.
Yes.
It's what we're talking about. That's kind of the difference between being an outsider and a newcomer.
Yes.
The outsider
yes.
says, hey, I'm going to bring all my tools, and you ought to do it the way we did it, because we did it this way in Chicago or
right.
Florida or wherever. And a newcomer says, I've got a toolbox here. Where can I build on?
Exactly. Exactly.
Well, I think Bentonville is a wonderful place to build on. Now, that great square that we saw, you have a lot of activities out there, too, don't
we do.
You? It's a
we
really
do.
Busy downtown where a lot of downtowns and towns this size have begun to fade away. But you guys have a lot of stuff going on.
We do. We have a lot of that going on. Well, the majority of the downtown events are provided by Downtown Bentonville. And that is an entity that helps put with the farmers market. They put the farmers market on
right.
on Saturday mornings, and then we have a First Fridays from March all the way until November. The first Friday of every month, there is something activity. Lunchtime, there'll be music and different food vendors, and then it goes on into the evening with the music, food vendors, a different theme every month, and that goes, like I said, until November. And the families come out, just visit. A lot of times, you know, it's for nothing in particular other than just to come out and see friends, just to say,
just
hey.
Hang out.
Yes, yes.
Well, they sure wave a lot around here.
We do. We do.